about World War I. And the first is called The Green Fields of France, and I did that one last night for David, actually, because it's his favorite. And someone else asked tonight, would you do either or? So in fairness, trying to keep the repertoire a little different on both nights, we're going to do a song called And the Band Played Waltzing Mathilda, which is truly, folks, I think, is the saddest song ever written. It's a song by Eric Bogle. It's about the First World War, when several thousand Australian troops were sent to the beaches of Gallipoli in Turkey. In a battle that raged for approximately 10 weeks, when it was all over and a head count was done, of the soldiers who had gone to fight, not very many returned home. Of those that did, not very many of them in one piece. The following song is written by Eric Bogle and dedicated to them. It's a song called The Band Played Waltzing Mathilda. When I was a young man, I carried my pack, and I lived the free life of a rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Mathilda all over. Then in 1916, my country said, son, it's time stop your rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat, they gave me a gun, and they sent me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Mathilda as we stopped to bury our slain. And amid all the cheers, the flag waving and the tears, we sailed off to Gallipoli. How well do I remember that terrible day when our blood stained the sand and the water. And how in that hell called Suba Bay, we were all butchered like lambs to the slaughter. Johnny Turkey was ready, yes, he primed himself well. He rained us with bullets and he showered us with shell. And in 9 minutes flat, we were all blown to hell. He nearly blew us back home to Australia. And the band it played Waltzing Mathilda as we stopped to bury our slain. We buried ours, the Turks they buried theirs. Then it started all over again. Those that were living, they just tried to survive in that mad world of blood, death and fire. And for 10 weary weeks, I kept myself alive, while all around me, the bodies piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me arse overhead. And saw what it had done, I wished I was dead. I never knew there were worse things than dying. So no more I'll go waltzing Mathilda all around the green bush far and near, for to hunt and to peg, a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Mathilda for me. Then they collected the wounded, the crippled and the maimed. They shipped us back home Australia. The armless, the legless, the blind and the insane, those proud wounded heroes of Super. And as our ship pulled into circular quay, I looked on at the place where my legs used to be, and thanked Christ there was no one there waiting for me. For to grieve, or to mourn, or to pity. And still the band it played Waltzing Mathilda as they carried us down the gangway. Nobody cheered. They stood there and they stared. And then they all turned their faces away. So now every April while I sit here on my porch, I watch the parades pass before me. I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, reliving their dreams of past glories. I see the old soldiers all tired, sick and sore, those weary old heroes of a forgotten war. And the young people ask, hey, what are they marching for? I ask myself the same question, but the bandit plays Waltzing Mathilda, and those older men still answer the call. But year after year, their numbers they get fewer, and someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Mathilda, waltzing Mathilda, who come a waltzing Mathilda with me? And the ghosts may be heard as you pass by that billabong. Who come a waltzing Mathilda with me?